Good morning, children. I hope that you all are keeping well. And today, I'll take your class, English language class. Today, we will see a new chapter, that is noun phrases. Before teaching noun phrases, let me tell you two different things. What is a noun and what is a phrase? As we define noun, noun is the name of a person, place, animal or thing. In a simple way, we can define noun. What is a phrase? A phrase is a group of two or more words that convey a short, single piece of information. A phrase has some meaning but does not express a complete thought. For example, the cheerful girl. So, the ginger cat, most extraordinary, profoundly talented, by the river, on the highway, very deep, give away, all of a sudden. So, this all examples tells us that a phrase does not have a subject and verb agreement and is usually a part of a clause or a sentence when we write. So now I hope both of the definitions are clear to you. So let's start the chapter noun phrases. Chapter number 7, noun phrases. Noun phrases. Noun phrases are phrases that perform the function of a single noun or pronoun. Please see. Noun phrases are the phrases that perform the function of a single noun or pronoun in a sentence. There will be a single noun and a single pronoun from which the noun phrase perform a function. A noun or pronoun is the head word of a noun phrase. Let's see the example. Salil / he. Only single noun Salil or pronoun he. Began to whoop and jump for joy. So noun as well as pronoun has been used here. Salil will be the word noun and he will be used as pronoun. So the noun phrase is performing a function with a single noun and pronoun. Now see, the excited little boy began to whoop and jump for joy. This is the single noun phrase. Only the little boy has been used. Now phrase has been added to it, the excited. The excited little boy began to whoop and jump for joy. Let's move on. The noun phrase replaces the noun or pronoun. Please pay attention, students. The noun phrase replaces the noun or pronoun. The head word of the phrase, that excited little boy, is boy. As I have told you, the phrase has been added to the sentence, that is the excited little boy. And the head word of the phrase, the excited little boy, is the boy. Now, she came with Meena. She came with her elderly aunt. Now you can see, the noun has been used. Now noun phrase has been used here. So you can see here, she came with her elderly aunt. So the head word of the her elderly aunt is aunt. Now see, we form noun phrases in the following ways. Let us begin with single noun, school. Determiner plus noun, the school. Simple way. Now quantifier plus noun, some schools. Not every school, but some schools. You can see here the underlined word it has been given. Determiner plus adjective plus noun. The biggest school, an important school. Single means noun has been used here. The biggest school, an important school. Numeral plus determiner plus noun. Two of the schools. There is a comparison between two schools. Two of the schools. Quantifier plus determiner plus adjective plus noun. Defines many of the finest school. So many of the finest schools have been compared. Many schools have been compared. We have started with the school, some school, the biggest school, important school, two of the schools, many of the finest schools, and now last and the sixth one, possessive plus noun. Her school, Janet's school. Now let's see pre-modifiers and post-modifiers. All the words in noun phrase that precede the noun are called pre-modifiers. And all the words in noun phrase that follow the noun are called post-modifiers. Now, what is the meaning of precede? Precede means to come and go, to happen, or to come and go before somebody or something. So, all the words in noun phrase that precede the noun are called pre-modifiers. All the words in a noun phrase that follows the noun are called post-modifiers. So let's see other examples also. Let's see. Some noun phrases are also formed with the help of the words that follow after the noun or pronoun. First, we can see here noun plus prepositional phrase. The man with a parakeet. The man with a parakeet. The groceries from the supermarket. Noun plus prepositional phrase. Now, second number, noun plus participle. The girl talking on the phone. The girl talking on the phone. Participle. The woman dressed in blue and black. The woman will become the noun and rest of the sentence you can see the participle. Noun plus complement. A host of daffodils. The purpose of your visit. The purpose of your visit. Noun plus relative clause. The cow that jumped over the moon. The player who won the award. Now come opposition. Our friend Seema, the naughty one, lives over there. To oppose something. That means our friend Seema, opposition, a naughty ones, live over there. Keats, the romantic poet, died young. So here the opposition has been given. Next is opposition at the end of the sentence. For example, my mother baked a cake for my friend. A rich chocolate cake. So, my mother baked a cake for my friend. A rich chocolate cake. Noun plus opposition at the end of the sentence. A rich chocolate cake. The romantic poet. A naughty one. This is opposition. So, I mailed her about the event. The forthcoming launch. So, the forthcoming launch will also become opposition at the end of the sentence. Some more example students, I want to tell you about pre-modifiers and post-modifiers of noun phrase. Let's see. Here we can see. You can see noun post modifiers. What is noun post modifier? Post means modifiers are modifiers coming after noun. Post modifiers are modifiers coming after noun. Remember, post means after. Post means after noun. Post modifier always comes after a noun. The most common post modifier is the prepositional phrase. As I have given you the example of the prepositional phrase, that is the man with the parakeet, the groceries from the supermarket. Now see here, the two main example from the prepositional phrase has been given. The book on a table. The book on the table. So on the table will become the prepositional phrase. And it is the post modifier because it comes after the noun, the book. The book is the noun and on the table is the prepositional phrase as well as post modifier that is coming after a noun. Now see the second sentence, civil conflict in Africa. Civil conflict in Africa. So the most common thing is civil conflict in Africa. Post modifiers coming after a noun. So here this is the most simple way I have made to make you understand that post means after and post modifiers are modifiers coming after a noun. And the most common modifier is the prepositional phrase. Always remember. And one simple example, the book on the table. And you can see more example also, the man with the parakeet. So the man will become the noun and the last with the parakeet will become the post modifiers. The groceries from the supermarket, the groceries will become the noun and the rest of the sentence will become the post modifiers. Let's see some more examples. See, it has been given here. A noun post modifiers. Post modifiers can be short, a dream, deferred or long. See, a girl who is wearing a pink scarf around her neck. A girl who is wearing a pink scarf around her neck. So it is telling post modifiers can be short or long. For example, a dream deferred or long means long post modifier. A girl who is wearing a pink scarf around her neck. So a girl will become a noun. Next will become the post modifier. Let's see the other examples also. Now let's see. Noun post modifiers. Post modifiers commonly answer traditional news. Please pay attention, students. Post modifiers commonly answer traditional news, reporting questions of who, what, where, when, how, or why. So, post modifiers commonly answer the traditional news, reporting questions of who, what, where, when, how, or why. Now please see some more examples. Noun post modifiers. Noun post modifiers commonly take the following forms. First is, the most common form is prepositional phrase. the dog in the store. The dog will become the noun and in the store will become the post modifier. ING phrase, the girl running to the school store. So the girl will become noun and running to the store will become the post modifier. The ED past tense that has been already passed away. The man wanted by the police. The man will become the noun and wanted by the police will become post modifier. WH clauses that we will study afterwards. I will tell you the more example about WH clauses with noun clauses. The house, noun, where I was born. That is the rest which is printed in the bold is post modifier. That which clauses, the thought, very important, the thought will become the clause, main clause, noun clause, and that I had yesterday will become the post modifier. That you can see here will become the post modifiers. I hope you have understood what is noun post modifiers. Now please pay attention, students. Noun post modifiers, please see. The noun together with all pre and post modifier constitute a single unit. Always remember, the pre and post modifier constitute a single unit. A noun phrase that indicates the complete reference. Any agreement in terms of singular, plural, with the noun at the center. Now let's focus on pre-modifiers. What is pre-modifiers or modification? Constituents with pre-modify nouns are determiner, adjectives, phrase and nouns. Let's see with determiners. Determiners. Determiners are of three types. Predeterminers specify quantity in noun which follow them. And they are of three major types. So specify quantity in the noun which follows them. And they are of three major types. Multiple expression, example, twice my salary. Fraction, example, half my salary. The words all and both, example, all my salary. So here you can see the pre-modification. Constituents with pre-modifying nouns are determiner, adjective, phrases and nouns. Let's move on. Let's see noun. Please pay attention. Noun also serve to pre-modify other nouns. For example, I bought a new computer game. The electricity board sent her a nasty letter. In these cases, noun pre-modifier is closely connected to the head noun that the two can almost be considered one word. You can see in both the cases, noun pre-modify is closely connected to head noun that the two can almost be considered one word. This illustrates that when noun pre-modify other nouns, they always come next to the head noun. Next to the head noun. Nothing else can come between them. For example, computer game, electricity board. Nothing can come in between these two words. So nothing can come between them. For example, I bought a new computer, new game. This is the wrong one. The correct sentence is I bought a new computer game. This is the wrong sentence. The correct sentence is I bought a new computer game. I bought a computer new game is totally wrong because nothing else can come between them because the noun is very closely connected. Premodifier, noun premodifier is closely connected to the head noun that the two can almost be considered one word. New game. New computer game. So I hope that you have understood this and the exercises. Try to do it by yourself and I will send you the exercises along with this explanation. Please go through the explanation at least one time, two time to understand what is noun phrase. Next time we will continue with the noun clauses. And if you go out, you are bigger students. So now, if you go out, wear a mask and stay home and stay safe. Corona has not gone. So please, unless and until it is not necessary, stay at home, stay safe. God bless you.